Hello, golfers. I'm Nick Cowper, golf coach in Hong Kong. This instructional video series is going to help you break 90. So stay tuned and let's have some fun. Staying safe during this difficult time for all of us around the world. As life is slowly starting to get back to normal and golf courses are opening up, I thought this would be a good time for me to release my first instructional video, How to Break 90. As there's too much information for just one video, I thought I would break this up into four individual instructional videos of How to Break 90. I'd like to send out a big thank you to all of my current subscribers for helping me grow my channel. But if you haven't already subscribed to my channel, now would be a good time to do so, and be sure to hit the notifications bell so you're updated of when I post a new video. I'm just going to hang out here for a minute, give you some time to do so. Have you subscribed? Just kidding. Let's get on with the rest of the video. So why 90? I think 90 is an important target score for golfers to reach, as it's a valid sign you're making substantial improvement, as breaking 90 is now bogey golf or better. You're going to start having a lot more fun, which is going to have you motivated to continue to improve. But before we get to the instructional content, let me first summarize each of the four videos within the series so you know what to expect. In this video, in video one, it's all gonna be about preparation. What you need to do to be best prepared to break 90 on the golf course. I'm gonna show you how to assess your game, come up with a mental and scoring strategy, and then be able to plan for course management. We're also gonna take a look at the equipment, what maybe you should and shouldn't have in your bag. Video two is going to be all about the short game, putting, chipping, and bunker play, and how you can practice that indoors in an environment like Hong Kong. Video three is all going to be about the full swing. With the full swing, I think we need to employ visualization and a pre-shot routine to help you feeling confident with your swing throughout the round. And video four is all going to be about execution. We're going to take these skills that we learned within the series out onto the golf course, and hopefully with one of my students, we're going to get him to break 90. In planning the production of this instructional series, I thought it would be most entertaining and relatable to you if I showed you how I would take your everyday typical golfer and get him over the hurdle of breaking 90. Within this video series, I'm going to feature one of my students, Joseph Lee, who's personally struggling to break 90. And hopefully through the lessons learned within this four video series, we can get him to break 90 in video four when we take him out onto the golf course. Video one, preparation. So how do we prepare? In preparing a strategy, mental strategy, and a scoring strategy, and a course management strategy to break 90 on the golf course, we first need to assess our golf game, and we need to take a look at our equipment. So in starting video one, I think it's a good time now that we meet my student, Joseph Lee. Let's go meet Joe.
Hello.
Hey, Joe.
Good morning.
Good to see you, man. Welcome to 61s.
Oh, thank you. Thank you. It's going to be a fun day.
Yeah, man. Lots of, you ready to break 90?
Oh, I'm so ready.
Oh, awesome, man.
All right. We got Joe here. It's good to have you here, Joe. So, Joe and I have been working together for a couple months now on a golf swing. And, you know, we've kind of talked about some of his goals. And breaking 90 is obviously a big goal of Joe. So why don't we meet Joe the golfer and find out a little bit about him. So, right. Joe, tell us about yourself.
Oh. All right. Hello, everyone. I'm Joe the golfer. I've been playing golf for around 4 years. I'll say 4.5 years. And I've been struggling to break 90s for the longest time. So that's why I'm here today. That's why you guys are gonna see for the next few sessions and see how I can improve my game with Nick.
Excellent. So as you viewers already know, there's a process and there's a preparation to this madness in breaking 90. So what we're first gonna do with Joe is we're gonna assess his golf game. So using Trackman technology and software, I've designed a couple of tests. We're gonna have Joe hit a series of golf balls throughout his entire bag, which is gonna help me then assess his strengths and weaknesses. And then from there, we can go ahead and start designing a plan specific to Joe. So why don't we go ahead and get started?
Let's do this.
So in assessing the irons, the iron play part of the assessment, I like to call this test, it's basically the traffic light. And I got this from an old mentor coach of mine back in the day. And what it is a green light, yellow light, red light, just like a traffic light. So the green light clubs are 50 yards to whatever you hit your pitching wedge carry distance. So in talking with Joe, we've kind of come up with the idea that he comfortably carries his pitching wedge about 110 yards. So that's his green light zone. His yellow light zone is 111 yards through whatever your comfortable 6-iron distance is. So yellow light is just what it sounds like, cautionary. So these are the clubs that we are attacking the pins with a little bit of caution. This is the yellow light zone. And then the red light zone is anything above your 6-iron carry distance. So in Joe's case, he comfortably carries his 6-iron about 160. So 161 onto that, say about 200 yards, you know, a golfer of about breaking 90 ability should be playing tees selected based on, right, par threes that really don't get over about 200 yards in distance. So this is the red light zone, 161 to about 200 yards. We're also then going to take a look at his 3-wood and hybrid and see how proficient he is with those clubs, because these are the clubs that he may be hitting off some par fours to play a better, you know, course management and strategy for the golf course. And then, of course, we're going to look at the driver and see how well Joe hits his driver. And I've put together a TPS, the Trackman Performance Studio driver test for that. All right, let's go ahead and get started. All right, buddy, you ready for the green light test?
Yep, I'm ready.
All right, so 50 yards to 110 carry.
That will be my 60, 56, 52, and my pitching wedge.
Excellent. Bud, good job with the green light test. Well done. Now we're on to the yellow light test, which is going to be 111 yards carry through the longest iron in your bag, which is, I think, a 6-iron, right? And we've estimated that to carry about what?
160.
160. Wonderful. So this is going to be yellow light test. So let's go ahead and get started. All right, bud, good job on the yellow test. So now we're on to the red light test, which is going to be basically your longest club in your bag other than your 3-wood and your driver. And it's going to cover a distance of, let's say, 161 through, I would say about 200 yards. So what club do you have in your bag which carries and covers that
yardage.
Well, for that distance, I only have two clubs left in my bag. I'm going to have to...
So what club do you have?
You've got a 5-iron.
Okay, so you've got a 5-iron and
then
you've got a hybrid. So that's a 22-degree tailor-made M4 hybrid,
yep.
Right?
Yep.
Which is equivalent of, let's say, a 4-iron.
Yep.
So excellent. So let's go ahead and start the red light test, and we'll see what the data says.
It's going to be fun.
All right.
Excellent job, Joe, on the green light, yellow light, red light test. So now we're on to the woods part of your test and assessment. And I noticed that you didn't have a 3-wood in your bag. Have you ever had a 3-wood?
I had one before.
Okay, so what happened to the 3-wood?
I'm scared of using my 3-wood.
Okay, so I'm sure a lot of you guys can relate. This is what we wanted to highlight. In the preparation part, is the equipment in your bag is a very important part, I think, in breaking 90 because, you know, as Joe pointed out, doesn't feel very confident with his 3-wood. So I think that's actually a very smart move on his part in taking out a club that he doesn't feel confident with because the last thing you want is to be out there on the golf course and maybe have a club in your bag that maybe we've probably all been there. You feel forced to hit because you know it's the correct play. But also in going through the assessment of Joe in the green light, yellow light, red light, I noticed that there is somewhat of a gap that he needs to fill with regards to distance because his 4-hybrid is carrying max really between 180, 190-ish yardage. And, you know, it's important to then have a club maybe that he can play off the tee aside from his driver on short par fours or maybe even long par fours that can get him in play. And really 190 yards is, I don't think, maybe long enough. So we are here at 61's Club Studio, which is a club fitting studio. We've selected here a 3-wood, which I think is going to suit Joe really nicely, with a UST Mamiya that's got the Addis MB fairway 55-yard regular shaft, which I think is a good shaft suited to his current swing speed. So we're just going to use this today, assess, have him hit a couple shots, and assess how this club might work and see how it might fit into his game. All right, let's give it a go.
Job. 2 carry. That was an excellent score.
All right, so the last part of the Trackman assessment, driver. Arguably, I feel probably the most important club in the bag, aside from the putter. You know, driving the ball well, putting well, both really important parts of scoring well. Like, what do you think about your driver? How do you feel you hit it?
That's a love and hate relationship, I would say.
Okay.
I'll say around 60%, 50 to 60% of the time, I'll hit it really the way that I want it to. Okay.
60% of the time, it works every time.
That doesn't make sense.
I love it.
Okay, good. So he sounds pretty positive and optimistic about it, so why don't we put it to the test and see how he does?
Let's go see if we can make this little kitty purr.
Report. So you can see your average carry is 212 yards with a total distance of 230. you can see your side total. You're averaging 61 feet to the right. So really 20 yards, let's call it 20 yards, 3 feet to a yard. So we're averaging about 20 yards to the right, which is something to take into account. So we're hitting a pretty significant little cut or slice consistently. And I think that's indicative of, you can see here, your club path is consistently going left over the top a little bit, and then your face angle is open. So that's a, you know, and I can say that with a lot of confidence, and, you know, and you're hitting it solid. Look at your smash factor. Your smash factor, you average 1.49. So it's not like you're mishitting these. You're hitting these very solid out of the middle of the club head, in the middle of the club face. So not bad from that perspective. We just need to improve your swing just a little bit. But this video is not about, you know, improving your swing and making your swing better. It's about how do we break 90 with your current skills. And I think we can really do that. I mean, if you know you've got a lot of consistency here, if we look down through the club path, all of these are pretty consistent going to the left. And you're generally, you've got a couple club face closed, you know, at, you know, closed a little bit at impact, but not that much. These are actually going to be pretty straight little baby cuts. And you can see here, you hit those the most solid. And it's really because you had the club face very square. So the ball speed, a lot of ball speed was transferred to the ball at impact. So those are probably, those are the best ones for sure. So yeah, I mean, look, I think a lot of really good information that that we can work with to get you, you know, more consistently in the fairway. I think for you, it's just about knowing your start lines off the tee, and we're going to talk about that later in this video about course management and, you know, getting you prepared to play the best.
So then once you visualize your shot shape, then I really believe it comes down to having one pre-swing swing thought that can help you best execute that shot, your shot. So that's something that you need to come up with in your own practice, in your practice sessions, right? What is a swing thought that helps you hit the ball the best? Now, this is something that, you know, I coach Joe, so this is something that through practice we have talked about and we're working on. But coming up with that one swing thought that's going to get him through the entire round, right? And this is one swing thought that you are going to be committed to and dedicated to throughout the round. This is not a swing thought that you're going to start changing throughout the entire round, right, to a new swing thought. It's very important that you stay committed to the swing thought through the entire 18 holes. If it doesn't work, then you come up with a new swing thought for the next 18. But that's the big part of this. We need to be committed. So the big part of having a sound mental strategy is good visualization, one, and then coming up with a one swing thought that can help you create that shot that you visualize. Before we tee off, it's also very important that maybe you look at having a scoring strategy. Now, what do I mean by a scoring strategy? So we're playing 18 holes of golf, right? And we can break that 18 holes of golf into 6 3-hole matches, if you will. So the benefit of this is that if something goes wrong in a hole, and you play a bit bad hole, let's say you make a double bogey on a hole, it allows you then to, after 3 holes is up, to be able to reset and start over with a fresh positive mindset. Typically on an 18-hole golf course, we have 4 par 3s, we have 10 par 4s, and we have 4 par 5s. So if pre-round, we mentally allow ourselves to play the par 3s 4 over,
So we bogey every par three. We play the par fours 10 over, so we bogey every par four. And then the four par fives, they're typically a little bit easier holes, right? Three shots to get to them, right? We allow ourselves to play the par fives 2 over par, right? If we add that up, 4 over, 10 over, 2 over, that's 16 over. And on a par 72, that would be 88. So we're two shots within our target score of 90. Now, why this is very important is because let's just use again, Calcite Chow East Course, the first three holes as an example. So we start with a par 5, par 4, par 3. Let's just say we start bogey, bogey, bogey. Typically, if you don't have this kind of plan in place, most of you out there would probably feel a little down on yourself, a little frustrated, right? I've just started bogey, bogey, bogey. This is going to be a terrible day. But if you have this pre-round mindset and plan in place, right, of bogeying maybe two of the par fives, bogeying all of the par fours, and bogeying all of the par threes, if you start bogey, 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 you're still within that plan and strategy. So it enables you to maintain a positive frame of mind, right, to continue on through the round. So this is very, very important before the round to, you know, pick the golf course apart that you're playing and come up with a plan pre-round so we can stay confident throughout the entire round. Course management. So before we tee off, it's really a great idea to have some sort of plan as how you're going to play the course relative to your physical abilities. So we've assessed Joe's strengths and weaknesses within his golf game. So we're going to give you the example of the 14th hole at Calcite Chow, the signature hole, a beautiful hole, but also a very challenging hole, as there's a lot of trouble on the left and the right if you are to hit a stray tee shot. A lot of you probably know the Calcite Chow 14th hole runs along the ocean. It's the hole that's on their, I think it's on their website, right? So it's a beautiful hole. But let's now walk you through how I would coach Joe in playing this hole. So as we know, from the white tee box, right, it's about 175 yards to the bunker, that first bunker off the tee, and it's about 195 yards to carry that bunker, right? Just carrying the bunker, we also know that it's about, 36 yards wide?
Yeah,
the fairway's about 36 yards wide. So obviously we want to carry the bunker with our shot, but In assessing Joe's ability, we know he average carries his driver about 212 yards, right? That's his average. So we know that he's well over that bunker. And then he max carry, I think we saw he carried it about 224 yards was the best one. So he's well over that bunker. But we also knew that Joe consistently hit about a 20-yard cut off the tee, consistently. So if we now pick the appropriate line off the tee, which I think is right over the center of that bunker, we know that we have enough room to the right at 36 yards wide at that point.
That's pretty good.
Yeah, to fit his shot into the fairway. So from about 220 to 260 is now the widest part of that fairway at 50 yards wide. So driver very comfortably, Joe knows standing on that tee, that he can just go ahead and rip his driver as hard as he wants, and he's got plenty of room to fit his driver in that area. It really comes down to, as we talked about earlier, visualization and visualizing his shot shape to pick an appropriate line off that tee, which is directly over the center of that bunker. So this is play devil's advocate in a second scenario. Right? Let's just say that you're well within this breaking 90 score and you're kind of protecting that you continue on that trend and reach this goal. Maybe he's a little bit nervous off the tee, or maybe he's actually hitting his driver poorly that day. It would not be out of the realm of possibility to maybe play 140, 150 yards short off the tee, then hit maybe another 100-yard shot down the fairway into that wide 50-yard zone.
That's comfortable.
Comfortable, right? Two easy shots. To then play a third shot, which is another strength of this game, from maybe 100 to 80 yards. Third shot onto the green, two putt, bogey, get out of there, and we're still within the plan. So these are some different ideas and some mindsets of playing the hole relative to what your physical abilities are and still achieving the end goal. So be sure to come up with a plan before you play the course and, you know, to have you feeling the most confident and reaching your goals. So after we assess Joe's physical abilities on the Trackman software, the next part of the preparation process is really assessing your equipment. So this is such an important variable in playing your best golf, is getting the right clubs in your hand. And through Joe's assessment, there were two glaring situations or instances from an equipment standpoint that stood out to me. The first, if you remember, was his three wood. So Joe didn't have a three wood in his bag for the obvious reason of that he just didn't feel comfortable with it and he didn't hit it very well. Now, in my experience fitting golf clubs, the three wood is probably the most difficult club to successfully fit to someone, as we're asking the three wood to do a couple of different things. Obviously, we want to be able to hit it off the fairway, hit it high and straight off the fairway. We also want to be able to maybe hit it off of the tee as an alternative to your driver. So I think adding a three wood to your game can be hugely beneficial, but we certainly don't want to put a club in our bag that we don't feel comfortable with. In Joe's assessment, we fit him here to a three wood and a shaft combination that I think was ideally suited to him. He hit a couple really great three woods. So that's something that him and I, player-coach relationship, will further explore. But the second thing, and probably the most alarming thing to me, was his irons and the shaft that he had in his wedges particularly was too heavy and too stiff. Just to give you an example, the swing weight of his 60-degree wedge was a D8, which is extremely heavy and poorly suited to his swing profile. So, however, this is a very common occurrence, I think, with many golfers, is they get clubs somehow, whether they're hand-me-downs or clubs that they buy off the rack with the shafts that are way too stiff and way too heavy. The moral of the story is, if you're invested in this game, I really think it's a good idea to spend the time and the money getting properly fit to equipment that's going to have you playing your best golf. Here at 61 Studio, we specialize in this. So if you are in the market to find some better equipment suited to your game, please don't hesitate to reach out to 61 Studio to help you with that process. For all of you golfers out there looking to improve, but have not gone through a process like I've shown here today, I would love to help you with your game. You can easily find me on social media, on Facebook and Instagram, at Nick Cowper Golf. So please don't hesitate to send me a direct message there. If you don't have social media, leave your comments below of this video, and I'll be sure to get in touch with you real soon. I'd love to hear all your feedback, comments, and questions about this video, so please leave those messages below. I'd love to hear from you all. I'd like to thank Joe for his time and his hard work today in being assessed. It's definitely not easy. He hit a lot of golf balls. And of course, I'd like to thank 61 Studio for this awesome location and filming this video. Be sure to watch out for video number 2 of the Breaking 90 series. We're going to be highlighting the short game.
I look forward to seeing you all then. Signing off with my favorite hashtag, Play Golf Hong Kong.